That's my boomer bloomer garden. I've been using it for a number of years, about 10 years now. For 8 years in a row, I was able to grow for 9.5 months a year. Now, that's boasting a little bit, but one thing I never knew was how much does it cost. So, anyway, not many people can grow into November. Too much time. So, anyway, I usually grow salad greens just because my yard is covered by trees and stuff, so I can't grow a garden like normal people. So I have to start out in March. I shovel to my garden, plant my seeds, and by about mid-May, I'm already into harvesting and stuff. So since I can't grow in the summertime because I don't get any light in my backyard, I have to do another garden starting around September into December. So it's just the nature of my beast here. So I really didn't know how much it costs in all those years I've been doing it. So I have this new device, and it's called Fill a Watt. What it does is it records the total amount of time that this device has been plugged in, and then I push this button again, it tells it how many kilowatt hours have been consumed over that number of hours. So with this chart now, I am able to track, I went into TV6 and I tracked all of the lowest temperatures of the day, and then you can see they're dropping, and then here is the cost of 12.6 cents per kilowatt hour. Those are the Marquette rates. So I now know that in the month of October, it cost me $5.90 to grow this garden. Now, this has four placements on here, so I'm only plugged into one of these gardens. The sensor is set 3 inches down, and so if I plugged all of these in and I had three more of these boxes, I'd have a total of 128 square feet of gardening space. And that now tells me from this chart that that 128 square foot garden through the month of October would cost me $23.60. So it's pretty reasonable, I think. Now here's something new that I didn't know about. It's a whole new fun thing to experiment with. My friend Ryan Iacovacci gave me some mushroom bits and pieces of wood with mixed in with different parts of mushrooms and stuff like that. And I didn't know what to do with it, so I was growing nothing in this area. So I scooped all this out, put in those mushroom cuttings and whatever they were. And then in 2 days, this all grew up and it was just covered in this white mass of mycelium. It looked like frozen fog. And then 2 days later, it was all gone. And so I talked to Ryan about it, and he said it probably the mycelium probably went underground and it's shooting around. So lo and behold, on the opposite end of the garden, right here, I've got my first mushrooms growing that I have never, ever, in all the years I've had this box, never saw a mushroom growing in here. So I'm wondering now, if I have a new toy to play with and something else to experiment with. So, anyway, I'm having fun with it.